In overwhelming darkness, light shines its brightest. In the midst of fear, peace brings relief. In our sinfulness, God's grace abounds. In the storms of life, there is a refuge. In our doubts, belief can be strengthened. And with the promise of a Savior, hope can be found. Lord, we live in darkness. Send us your light. Lord, we live in fear. Relieve us with your peace. Lord, we live in doubt. Strengthen our belief. I was crushed when God found me. My heart was broken, and my pain was overwhelming. In so much despair, and with nowhere to turn, I wondered how long I could survive. I cried out for help. God, save me! The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves anyone whose spirit is crushed. The righteous may have many troubles, but God will deliver them from all troubles and bring them to a place of refuge and rest. And God heard me, giving me grace and hope long before the first words of my prayer were even spoken. Lord, our lives are chaotic. Help us find your refuge. Lord, you promised a Savior. Send him today. Lord, we wait in hope. Send Messiah today. Send him, Lord, we pray.
Thank you.
In a world filled with worry and fear, God is our refuge and strength. I was so afraid, it seemed like everywhere I turned, I faced problems. No job, overdue bills, aging parents. I was so paralyzed by worry, I couldn't take care of anything. I was drowning in hopelessness, until the words of a child reminded me of God's promise. Don't you know? Haven't you heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of earth. God will not grow tired or weary. God strengthens the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even the young grow tired and weary. Even the young grow weary, stumble and fall. But anyone whose hope is in the Lord will have a renewed spirit and will mount up with wings like eagles. They will run and not get tired. They will walk and not become weary. It took humble words spoken by a small, sweet voice to remind me to fully trust in God. The stress and despair ceased. Here's hope. God is able to take care of us no matter what we need. No matter our weakness, God is very present and will provide help in times of trouble and doubt.
Thank you.
God saw his people waiting in hope for his light to end their darkness. God sent an angel to Mary, telling her of the prophecy she would fulfill. At the right time, God sent Jesus to be born. God sent angels to reveal his son's birth to shepherds. Gloria, the Savior is born. Gloria, praise God in heaven. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Join as the angels rejoice. Darkness is ended. God's light has come. Lord, we praise you. Angels filled the sky, announcing hope is born. Lord, we thank you. I sat silently, weeping as I had so many times before, feeling hopeless and alone. But then I felt a gentle hand on my shoulder. I was no longer alone. Someone sat next to me, comforting. He shared with me the strength, hope, and love found in God's merciful grace. In faith, I too found hope in God's mercy. My soul rejoices, and I, like the shepherds, share in the joy and hope in the arrival of Messiah. Like the prodigal, we were lost, but now, in your mercy, we are found. Thank you, God, for your grace.
Good.
Like Mary and Joseph welcoming your son, Lord, help us greet each new day with joy. Like Magi following the star, Lord, help us seek your light. Like all those who came before us, let us worship your chosen one. Holy God, we worship you.
Oh.
Long ago, the world waited in darkness. You sent your Son, your light. Now we wait once more for your Son to appear. We see as through a mirror. Our sight is imperfect at best. Yet in you I find strength and love. You are able to provide for all our needs, and you still rescue the lost. But when the Savior returns, our eyes will be opened, and the imperfect will pass away. We will see clearly. Our sight will be complete. Our faith will be fulfilled. So let us share God's love with others as we wait in hope once more.